In my last class, I was discussing about variable, and it becomes the most important concept when it comes to carrying or conducting any research. This, because a lot of people, they ignore this stuff. And once they ignore it, they never realize that even after conducting the entire research, they have nothing in their hand to present. Because by definition, variable is anything that changes. So anything that is fixed, that is constant, is not in our scope. If it is constant, that's another important thing. So, for example, it's possible that something is constant at one level and it becomes a variable at another level. What do I mean by this? That, for example, if I will going to consider the MPhil class enrolled in Department of Zoology. So at the level of your class, your number of years of education. It's a constant at the level of your class that you all have 16 years of education and you have qualified 16 years. So no one will going to conduct any research as far as your education level is concerned, because it's all about the constant, and you know that nothing will going to change within your class. So number of years of education is constant at the level of your class. But if I'm carrying out a research in Department of Zoology, instead of using your class, I just switch to the Department of Zoology. In that case, the number of years of education, it becomes a variable. It becomes a variable because in Department of Zoology we have BS students who have 12 years of education, we have MSc students who has 14 years of education, and then we have MPhil students who have 16 years of. So at the level of Department of Zoology, the zoology, thus as a specialization, is constant. And no one, there is no reason why someone is going to consider the zoology in Department of Zoology, because everyone has a specialization in zoology. There is no other option available. But if I was going to just switch from my scope from Department of Zoology to the Faculty of Sciences. In the Faculty of Sciences, the subject or the specialization, it becomes a variable, because in Faculty of Sciences we have zoology, we have chemistry, and we have so on. The only purpose of explaining all that stuff is to tell you that maybe something is constant at one level and it becomes a variable at another level. So without looking, without having all those descriptions, without description, without have complete knowledge, you cannot decide whether it's a constant or variable. So no one in this world will going to tell you, okay, these are the variables that exist in world, and these are the constant that exist, because something is constant at one level and it becomes a variable at another level. So you need to look at your research, that what are the constant in your research and what are the things that are variable in your research. And your entire focus is always on variable. And I gave you a horrible situation that if someone has an objective to tell about the epidemiology and he has data of only positive cases. In that case, the disease status is constant in his data, because he has data of only positive cases, so there is no negative case. So the disease status is positive for all, so it becomes a constant. From only the positive cases, no one in this world can calculate the prevalence. And these small mistakes, to all the carry, mean made by the new researcher, creates a lot of lots of trouble for them. Because sometimes they have to conduct their entire study again. So first, you need to look for the variable. And from the variable, I told you there are two types of variable. One is the dependent variable, and other one is the independent variable. And I will going to use one thing. Let's suppose cholesterol level in the body. What do you think? Is it a dependent variable or an independent variable? Please give me your opinion.
Sir, dependent variable.
Are you sure it's a dependent variable?
Sir, independent.
So there is a gentleman who told me that it's independent. And this is something that lot of people, they carry that perception with me from my lectures, that okay, it's independent and dependent. So some said that it's independent, and then some have a very fixed view that it's dependent. So please share your opinion, that on which ground you decide that it's an independent variable, and on which ground you have decided that it's a dependent variable. I request you to please contribute, otherwise I will be teaching my laptop. Accept my apologies for this horrible handwriting on this laptop, because I'm not good with this mouse. And even the pen I'm using, I'm not still comfortable with this. What made you to choose that, okay, I decide that it's an independent variable? Just make yourself feel comfortable and tell me what came in your mind when you decided, okay, it's dependent or independent variable.
Gentlemen, actually cholesterol level depend upon, I think, body weight. I mean, more body weight, you have more cholesterol level.
It does not, once I will write here what you believe, it does not mean that I agree with this. But still, that a gentleman thought that, okay, the body weight depends on cholesterol level. And there was a lady who told me that, okay, I think it's a dependent variable. On which ground you decide that it's a dependent variable? Lady, I'm waiting. Please, just feel free and tell me. I'm waiting. We do not have lots of time.
Sorry, sir. Repeat kijiyega question, sir. Sorry.
You told me that it's a dependent variable. Was it true?
जी सर, मुझे लगता है ऐसा है, क्योंकि कोलेस्ट्रॉल लेवल फूड और दूसरी चीजों पे डिपेंडेंट होता है, जिसकी वजह से इसमें तब्दीली आ सकती है.
सो व्हेन आई रोट द वर्ड कोलेस्ट्रॉल लेवल, द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट इज दैट केम इन द माइंड ऑफ जेंटलमैन वाज दैट ओके, इट हैज समथिंग टू डू विद बॉडी वेट, सो cholesterol will be independent, and then the body weight will going to depend it depend on it. Another lady, she thought, okay, it's the cholesterol level, and cholesterol level depend on the food intake. So on one person thought that, okay, it's a dependent variable. Another person thought that it's independent variable. And this is where we all become judgmental. Judgmental means that we start judging a thing without having a complete knowledge. Complete knowledge means the information means in order to decide something, in order to make a decision, you need to have the complete information. This is fundamental aspect of research. You are not supposed to assume anything. And on the basis of that assumption, you just decide something. Yes, you are free to assume, but you have to test your assumption. And after testing, you need to decide. So there must be three steps. One is the assumption, and then you need to test your assumption, and then you need to decide. If you decide directly based on your assumption, that will be something wrong without testing. And how the testing is possible? For testing, you need to have the complete information. The purpose of entire practice is to give you a very clear idea that if I will going to write down cholesterol level, so you are practicing science and you are practicing logic. So in order to become a dependent or independent, you need to have information about the other variables as well. You cannot simply decide. I told you that like your constant and variables, they are not fixed. It depends on what kind of study it is. Maybe it's a constant for one study. At another level, it becomes a variable. The story remains the same when it comes to the dependent and independent variable. Maybe a variable is independent at one level. But at another level, it may be dependent. So if I'm going to relate my study at that, if my study is like this, that lipid intake, association of the lipid intake with cholesterol level. So in this case, as the cholesterol level, it depends on lipid intake. So cholesterol will be my dependent variable. And if you consider the diet, it will be independent variable.
Sir, excuse me.
Yes.
Sir, it meant to check a thing. Either it's independent or dependent, we must have two or more than two things.
In order to decide independent or dependent variable, you need to have complete information. What do I mean by the complete information? That you need to have the other variable as well. Without other variable, you cannot decide a single variable as independent or dependent variable.
Okay, sir.
So I just wrote down the cholesterol level because I know that most of the people, they just decide, okay, they decide randomly, okay, this is independent and it's independent variable without thinking that what kind of study it is. And once they they are wrong in their choices regarding the dependent and independent variable, in that case, what they will going to get at the end of their research? Nothing. Maybe they have missed a very, very important variable. And maybe if they consider something else, that if their dependent variable is not real dependent variable, whatever they have assumed as dependent variable is actually not a dependent variable in their study, in that case, they will be in crisis because they will not going to meet those objectives, because I told you that your objective must be in line with your title. And then your variables, they must be in line with your objectives, because these are the variables which you will going to use, and you will going to get that data from these variables, and on the basis of that data, you will going to decide about those objectives. So if your data source is not appropriate, then you will fail to decide. And even if you are going to decide it by yourself, that will be something wrong. Another thing, that in any class, no one can just give you a list that these are independent variable and these are dependent variable. Although with most of the cases, we have dependent variable and independent variable, that there are quite clear, but there is so much space for confusion and ambiguity. And people, they simply ignore it and they got trapped. So as no one can provide you, because nothing is fixed, no one can provide you a list of dependent and independent variable. So you need to look, because a variable is independent at one level and a variable is dependent at another level. So just you need to look at your research, and then you need to decide about the variable. Which are the dependent variable in your research and which are independent variable in your research. For example, if someone is going to carry out a study that if cholesterol level, association of the cholesterol level with the heart attack. So here they have two variables. One is the cholesterol level and other one is the heart attack. In this case, what's your dependent variable? Please update me so that I can continue. If someone is interested to know about the cholesterol level, association of cholesterol level with heart attack. Gentlemen, please update me. Which will be your dependent and independent variable?
Sir, no idea. Sir, actually, we have some previous knowledge.
Just feel free. You can use any language. No issue.
Okay, sir. Sir, मैं ये कहना चाह रहा हूँ कि बाज़ उकात हमारे पास previous knowledge भी होता है. तो उसकी बेस पे हम अपने वेरिएबल को डिसाइड कर सकते हैं कि कौन सा डिपेंडेंट है और कौन सा इंडिपेंडेंट है.
यू एक्सक्लूसिवली डिसाइड ऑन द बेस ऑफ योर प्रीवियस नॉलेज.
ओके सर. तो सर प्रीवियस नॉलेज की बेस पे हम कह सकते
हैं, देयर इज नो अदर सोर्स ना.
यस सर. तो सर अगर मोर कोलेस्ट्रॉल लेवल है बॉडी के अंदर, तो इट मीन मोर चांसेस ऑफ हार्ट अटैक.
दैट्स वेरी क्लियर. सो हियर यू हैव योर डिपेंडेंट.
इट मीन हार्ट अटैक डिपेंड अपॉन more cholesterol level.
It's all about the cholesterol. So here in this case, hopefully the cholesterol do not depend on heart attack.
Yes.
Is it true? Is it possible that someone is going to claim that if someone will have more heart attack, ultimately that leads to the more and more cholesterol level? It's not possible.
Not sir, aisa hi.
The cholesterol level, the heart attack depends on cholesterol level. And that's very clear. So here the cholesterol level is independent, and the heart attack is, frequency of heart attack is dependent. In my previous study, the lady gave me an example that the lipid intake and the cholesterol level, in that case, the intake of lipid do not depend on cholesterol level. But the cholesterol level depends on lipid intake. So here, the cholesterol level becomes the dependent variable. And that decision is exclusively based on your previous knowledge. Is it clear? This is not I'm not asking from you, I am asking from everyone. Anyone has any confusion regarding this? So hopefully, once you are going to start your research, you are going to look at your variables. And then you are going to decide about your dependent variable and independent variable carefully. And few more lines that will going to stabilize that the value of your dependent variable will be always random in your research. While even if you are carrying out any experiment, you cannot manipulate your dependent variable. You cannot change. If you are carrying out an experimental design. While when it comes to the independent variable, first, it has a fixed value. You can choose. Normally, a researcher manipulates the independent variable. For example, if someone looks for the association of the if someone wants to know about the how much the fertilizer has their impact on yield. So the person can change fertilizer because fertilizer is independent. So it's the choice of a researcher that whether they want to choose 1 kilogram, 2 kilogram, 10 kilogram. So it's all their choice. But when it comes to the yield, they have no control on it. So yield will be the dependent variable and it will have a random value. And the researcher do not have any control on yield, so it has a random value, so that's why it's dependent. Fertilizer, a researcher can choose, it can fix it, and a researcher can change it, can manipulate it. So anything that you can manipulate, anything that you have the capacity to change will be your independent variable. Is it absolutely clear? Do you need any further explanation?
Sir, ye control nahi hoga jisko hum control kar sakte hain.
Just give me a single example where you have the capacity to control the dependent variable.
Sir, dekhen hum agar fasal ke liye koi dana dalte hain to agar dane kisan ke bas mein hote hain ki wo usko jitna dale us hisab se phir aage depend karta hai ki wo kitni fasal hogi. तो ये हम कंट्रोल वेरिएबल नहीं है यानी अगर हम ज्यादा डालेंगे तो ज्यादा होगी और कम डालेंगे तो शोर सी बात है कि कम होगी
सो योर क्वेश्चन हैज टू कंपोनेंट एंड यू नीड टू इट्स वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू जस्ट एड्रेस देम सेपरेटली द फर्स्ट एस्पेक्ट इज दैट यू यूज जस्ट used an example of seed. And then you relate it with the yield. So in that case, you told me that, okay, my seed is independent variable and my yield is dependent variable. And then you relate it with another logic that the more seed I will going to introduce to a field, the more yield I will have. And so it's clear that I have control on my yield by adding more and more seeds. So if I'm going to add more and more seeds, I will have more and more yield. You used an example of a universal truth. where there is no ambiguity. It's a universal truth that the yield is dependent on seed. Rather, everything you have, if you do not introduce that. So when we do the research, what's the purpose of carrying out our research that deals with the universal truth that everyone in the world, there is no ambiguity regarding this, there is no confusion regarding this. So in research, we do not deal with universal truth that is accepted everywhere. Whenever you will going to carry out a research that relates with the dependent variable and the independent variable, you want to know that whether that your dependent variable depends on independent variable or not. What kind of association you have, because you want to answer that question. And do you think it's reasonable to answer a universal truth? Because people, they already know this. So that's the one part of your question. Have you got my point?
Yes, sir.
Is there anyone who is going to carry out a research that relates to that, okay, seed and the yield? That if we do not introduce the seed to a field, we will not going to get any yield. Do this requires any research? Because we carry out the research to answer the question, and that was from my first lectures. That what's the source of research? Because you have a question that is never being addressed. That is never being answered. And do you think when it comes to the seed and yield, do you think that question requires to be addressed? I think you do not think so. Because it's a universal truth. Everyone is very, very sure about it. Another example could be, I'm just using food. I'm not using any protein, lipids or anything. Food intake and weight gain. In that case, food intake will be your independent variable, and then weight gain will be your dependent variable. And you can, with certainty, you can claim that if you do not take in any food, you will not going to gain any weight. The weight gain is only possible with food intake. So once again, it's a universal truth. People, they work with protein, they work with lipids, but they work with carbohydrates. But they do not work with this one, because that's universal truth. Are you getting my point? That's the first part of my explanation. Do you agree with that explanation? Just feel comfortable.
Yes, sir, I agree.
Gentlemen, you never asked this question. There was a lady who asked me.
Sir,
any one of you can continue, please.
Sir, actually, इसके साथ ही एक और चीज़ है ना कि ये एक से ज़्यादा factors के ऊपर depend कर रहा है. तो I think उनका question यही था कि बाज़ का वो जब seed डालता है फसल के लिए, तो फसल बाज़ का कम होती है, बाज़ का ज़्यादा होती है, factor बाकी भी शामिल होते हैं, तो उस हिसाब से हमें आप guide करें.
Whatever I have understood from her question, Kiji, we can control the yield, dependent variable. Control the dependent variable in a way that as we will going to introduce more and more seeds, we will have more and more yields. So I claim that we do not have a complete control on dependent variable. Because it has a, my claim was that your dependent variable has a random value. And she said that we do have control on dependent variable, because once we can control the dependent variable through independent variable. The more seed we're going to introduce, the more yield I have. So lady, it's up to you that tell me who understood your question appropriately.
जी सर, आपने सही बताया, लेकिन सर इसके साथ मेरा एक और क्वेश्चन भी था कि जो आप इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल की बात कर रहे हैं, आपने कहा कि हम उसको फिक्स कर सकते हैं. फिक्स करने के बाद हम यील्ड को देख सकते हैं कि वो ज़्यादा भी हो सकती है, कम भी हो सकती है. तो सर मैं इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल के बारे में पूछना चाह रही थी कि अगर वो फिक्स्ड होती है तो वो कंट्रोल्ड में आएगी।
Yes, the independent variable is always in the control of the researcher. But I do not use the word control because in normally the when we use the word control, people they feel that in the trials of medicine there is a word like control on this. So instead of using the word control, I use the word fixed because there are certain kind of research in especially in medicines where they have a control group. And what do they mean by the control group is that a group where they do not introduce any medicine, a group where they never manipulated anything. So they refer it as a control group. So instead of using the word control, I use the word fix, because in medicine trials there is a word that is very very much accepted word, that is the control group. Control means a group that is not being offered with any treatment or anything, and they use that group for comparison. So if you want to replace the word fix with control, I do not have any objection if you understand the concept. But you can
sir,
control
मैंने...
on. Yes, please. Just feel comfortable okay. and ask.
Sir, so, मैंने जो variable की types पढ़ी हैं, उनमें तो independent, dependent and controlled is the third form of variable. Sir, मैं उस sense में पूछ रही हूँ.
Are you sure?
जी sir.
Just share me the literature that at any time when you are going to see the word control with this aspect, there is a third variable that is control.
Dependent. Sir, अभी तो मेरे पास literature नहीं है.
Okay, okay, no issue. We will going to discuss that thing in at the start of next lecture. Is it okay?
Okay, sir.
But what I am telling you right now that at any time when they will going to use the word control, what does they mean? That they will going to tell you that we have a treatment group. Let's suppose they offered medicine A to group one, and then they may have another group. They offered medicine B. It can be many many groups. So if they are comparing medicine, and then they have a control group. And what they mean by the control group is that they offered no medicine. But I do not know why they have discussed it with you at somewhere when you were discussing that independent and dependent, and then there is a control. Rather, there is another term that is confounding variable. Maybe you heard something, because when we discuss the dependent and independent variable, we discuss a third kind of variable, confounding variable, that is linked with this. But I never heard the word like control, so I was going to leave it right now and wait for your literature, and then I was going to read it and then we'll comment on it. So secondly, the second part of explanation regarding your question, that seed and the yield, even if you are going to introduce more and more seeds, still you cannot fix the yield. Although it will be increased, but still you cannot fix the yield to a specific value. It will be increased, but you cannot exactly tell before actually you have yield product in your hand that how much yield you will have once you are going to put a specific amount of seed. So even with this universal truth, you cannot fix the yield before even getting the yield, because it will vary. And it will vary, the gentleman rightly said, because there are other variables that can affect it. They can be fertilizer, they can be the irrigation practices, they can be fertility of soil, and they can be even depend on what kind of seed you are using, because certain seed they give more yield, certain other kinds of seeds, they were going to give less yield. So these are all factors that contribute to this. So that concludes my discussion on variables for a limited period of time until unless you are going to give me some literature. Is it okay? Lady, do you have any other question? Just feel free and ask.
No, sir.
And now we're going to switch to the hypothesis. Can anyone define what is hypothesis? Just feel free.
Sir, sir, any statement which can be tested.
Yes, that's the perfect definition of hypothesis. That any statement that can be tested is hypothesis. There are other statements as well that can be considered as hypothesis. For example, if someone will going to claim that maybe this has happened 5 million years ago. Once again, it's a hypothesis, and someone claimed that, okay, 5 million years ago, this thing has happened in that part of the world. In that case, that also statement needs to be tested, but it's not testable. So all those statements that cannot be tested are not in our scope. So we generate hypotheses that can be tested based on those objectives and the variables. So it's a compulsion on you to generate the hypothesis for your research. And when it comes to the hypothesis, normally they come in pair. You have null hypothesis and alternate hypothesis. Null hypothesis, once again, I repeat all those things. Gentlemen, what can be a part of null hypothesis? Because when you are testing any statement and you are generating a testable hypothesis, that hypothesis always comes in the form of a pair. And another name for alternate hypothesis is experimental hypothesis. And I'm using the previous example. Now tell me, is it an alternate hypothesis or null hypothesis? That if I will going to write down a word like this, cholesterol level. Increases high cholesterol level increases the frequency of heart attack. So on the basis of those variables, I generated a statement, and that statement is required to be tested. So I have a statement like this, that high cholesterol level increases the frequency of heart attack. Is it null hypothesis or alternate hypothesis?
Alternate, sir.
Yes, this is alternate, because anything that any statement that shows the association cannot be a part of your null hypothesis. It can only be a part of alternate hypothesis. Another example could be fertilizer affects the yield. What statement this is? Please, there is distortion in your voice. Please repeat your explanation. Accept my apologies. Maybe I do not have a good internet connectivity, or maybe you do not have a good internet connectivity. So I'm listening. Just feel free and tell me what you want to say.
सर अल्टरनेट हाइपोथेसिस है वो भी यही
है वंस अगेन दिस कैन नॉट बी अ पार्ट ऑफ नल हाइपोथेसिस बिकॉज़ नल हाइपोथेसिस शोज दैट नथिंग इज कॉज एंड नथिंग इज इफेक्ट सो एनीथिंग दैट शोज अ रिलेशनशिप ऑफ कॉज एंड इफेक्ट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ योर अल्टरनेट हाइपोथेसिस सो व्हाट विल बी द नल हाइपोथेसिस The statement that can be accumulated in null hypothesis, it will be always like this, that cholesterol has no effect on frequency of heart attack. The fertilizer has no effect on yield. And maybe if you are testing two groups in that case, for example, if you are testing medicine A and medicine B. So if I have a claim, let me switch to a new slide. If I have a claim, if I want to test two medicines, or even if I am interested to test a single medicine, that medicine A is offering recovery against a disease. Or another way to use the offering the recovery is effective. Against a disease, any disease, disease A, B, C, it can be any disease X. So what will be the statement if you are testing a single medicine for efficacy? Is it a null hypothesis or alternate hypothesis?
Sir, alternate ही होगा ये भी क्योंकि हम इसमें experiment करेंगे जी.
Yes. Mean medicine A is effective against disease because null hypothesis in the statements of null hypothesis you cannot claim anything that anything has effect on anything so your null hypothesis will be that medicine A has no effect on disease so where you show no effect it's always null hypothesis so your null hypothesis will be no effect Alternate hypothesis, it will be effective again. If you are comparing two groups of anything, water contamination in an area A and water contamination in an area B. So we are working with environmental water contamination and you want to carry out a comparison. Maybe it's two different water sources. You are comparing a canal water with groundwater. Maybe you are comparing the groundwater of two different locations. So these are all kind of, maybe you are comparing the efficacy of two different medicines. In that case, what will be your null hypothesis and alternate hypothesis? What will be your null hypothesis? In that case, the null hypothesis statement will be like this always, that water contamination in area A is equal to water contamination in area B. And your alternate hypothesis will be that water contamination in area A is different from area B. So any statement that shows the difference is always a part of your alternate hypothesis. And anything that shows the equality is always null hypothesis. I was going to stay with my yarn statement. Null mean equal. Equal means zero. Zero mean no cause, no effect. No cause, no effect mean no predictor, no outcome. No predictor, no outcome means no association. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Just make yourself feel comfortable and ask if you have any question. Okay. So that concludes my discussion on objectives, variables, title, objective, variables, and hypothesis. And now we're going to talk about research design. Do you have any question regarding this? Just feel free.
और ये बिल्कुल जनरल रहा है टॉपिक, हम इसमें टेस्टिंग नहीं पढ़ेंगे इसकी, या जो एरर वगैरह इसके अंदर आते हैं हाइपोथेसिस के टेस्टिंग के दौरान?
Problem is that I have a separate course of experimental statistics, so normally that is also included in this course. So as you are already familiar with so many things regarding the statistics and we carried out all those stuff, so I'm just ignoring that fact. Mean it's nothing else.
Okay,
that
sir.
When it comes to the testing, you have to apply various statistical tests, and hopefully I have discussed each and every test during your master, so I'm just ignoring them. But still, if you want, I can. But I have a separate course. Secondly, if anyone who is still interested in that case, they can join my class of MSc, because I will going to start the inferential statistics in a couple of days. So they are more than welcome to join me there. Even if they do not, because that will be reputation for so many people. Because you know how to carry out a t-test, pair t-test, single sample t-test, f-test, you know about ANOVA, simple randomized design, completely randomized design, completely, so CRT, RCBT, randomized complete block design, and we discuss about, secondly, if this is an observation study, we discuss about one-way ANOVA, two-way ANOVA, chi-square analysis, regression, correlation, we discuss everything. How many of you were previously enrolled during the master? So I'm not just repeating everything. Have you completed all these things during your masters? And tell me about the strength. How many people I have new for MPhil who do not have all these things, who haven't completed all these things during your masters? Just update me so that I can. Why you are silent? Do you remember that stuff from your masters?
No, sir.
Yes, sir. किसी और
का लोग हैं फिर जिन्होंने मास्टर्स इधर से किया है, बाकी आउटर ही हैं.
So what do you want me to do? Let me stop the recording and then we can discuss.